This has been one of the worst disasters Australia's ever faced, but it's brought out the best in Australians. There have been many remarkable acts of generosity and heroism that have come out of this shocking turn of events.
They say when bad things happen, good people come running. Victims have been strengthened by strangers, and ordinary people have become extraordinary heroes.
Yeah, just thought I'd come out here with my dad and help clean up the mess.
Do you know these guys?
Nah, we don't. Just friendly offer.
Mark Kempton's home is flooded, but he's spent the last 3 days winching others to safety, plucking 28 people from the floodwaters.
It's just a heartbreaking thing. It doesn't matter how many people, you know, you save. What you do, you always want to just get someone else, one more, you know. You want to get everyone, you know, and you just can't.
Care, courage and kindness are overflowing in evacuation centres, children even donating their own toys to those who've lost everything. And footy players from all codes, from every state, are chipping in.
We're going to be, you know, getting stuck in. They're not just going up there to stand around. We're going to be doing our best and helping out as many families as we can.
Emergency crews from around the country are heading to the heart of the tragedy.
It will be very, very difficult. By its nature, it's likely to be dangerous, but is absolutely necessary.
More police will also head to Queensland on Monday to bolster the anti-looting task force.
For security, for the safety and for the confidence of the public, we believe this is an important thing to do.
Fellow Australians are showing remarkable generosity, donating everyday essentials. But much more money is needed before these people can even dream of rebuilding their lives that have been obliterated by Mother Nature's extraordinary force. Natasha Rixelby, 10 News.